Hello and welcome to the episode 210 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. The world premiere of Help, a big negative reaction to an old interview, and the rehearsals for Hey Jude are among the stories we'll focus on today. In 1957, a 15-year-old Paul McCartney went on holiday to a scout camp in Derbyshire, leaving the question of whether or not he should join the quarrymen unresolved. On the 29th of July 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed at the Blair Hall in Liverpool. It was another peak promotions night. 3 years later, in 1964, we get the second night at the Johanneshovs Isstadion in Stockholm, Sweden. Once again, the Beatles had a first concert at 6:45 p.m. and a second at 10 p.m. Overall, while not all of the performances were sold out, the 2 days of concerts went well, and the Beatles also managed to appear on Swedish television discussing their future. In 1965, the Beatles' second feature film, Help, premiered at the London Pavilion Cinema on Piccadilly Circus. Help was a good film, enjoyable, but it seems that the Beatles felt it was a step back from A Hard Day's Night. John later declared that the band ended up as guests on their own film, caught up in a big plot and surrounded by a too strong supporting cast. It was probably for this reason that the Beatles didn't take part to a fictional feature film for the rest of their career, despite numerous rumors and proposals throughout the years. On the 29th of July 1966, US teen magazine Datebook reproduced a 4th of March Evening Standard interview to John Lennon, putting a quote on the cover. "I don't know which will go first, rock and roll or Christianity." You might want to check out episode 63 of What A Fab Day for the whole story, but to refresh your memory, the entire quote was, "Christianity will go, it will vanish and shrink. I needn't argue about that, I'm right and I will be proved right. We're more popular than Jesus now, I don't know which one will go first, rock and roll or Christianity. Jesus was alright, but his disciples were thick and ordinary. It's them twisting it that ruins it for me." Since March, in the United States alone, the Evening Standard item had been published in syndication in Newsweek, New York Times Magazine, and Detroit Magazine, well before it hit Datebook, always without any reaction from the public. This time, it caused a gigantic uproar. Perhaps it was due to the magazine public, mostly teens. Perhaps it was the magazine's liberal outlooks, with its scandalous treatment of interracial dating and legalization of marijuana. Or perhaps it was the desire of Datebook editor Art Unger to stir controversy. Above the infamous Lennon quote on the cover, Paul McCartney is quoted saying about the United States, "It's a lousy country where anyone black is a dirty nigger." Whatever the reason, the matter quickly escalated. In Birmingham, Alabama, WAQY Radio spearheaded an initiative that quickly rounded up another 22 radio stations and countless listeners, banning the Beatles' music from the air, and stage and broadcast public destructions and burning of Beatles' albums, merchandise, and memorabilia to show the band that they couldn't get away with their sacrilegious ideas. This will not be the last time we discuss the matter. In 1967, George Harrison, his wife Patty, and Beatles assistant Mal Evans returned to England from Greece, where they had enjoyed a holiday while visiting islands for a possible real estate deal, as we have seen in episode 207 of this podcast. 1 year later, in 1968, the Beatles started to work on one of their most famous pieces, Hey Jude. With George Martin unavailable, they worked alone at the EMI studios, with their new sound engineer Ken Scott in the producer's seat. The Fabs recorded 6 takes of the song, 3 of which complete. These were little more than rehearsal takes, but Take 2 was released with the Anthology 3 album in 1996, although faded out early. The session, started at 8:30 p.m., was wrapped up at 4 a.m. By the way, have you shared this episode? If you do, the whole world will notice how fab your podcast tastes are, and your friends might decide to join our daily immersion in the history of the Beatles. A bigger community means more fun, and more fun means that everybody is happier. As usual, if you fancy doing something extra to help me to produce more and better music-related content, please visit www.simonmas.com/support to find out what is needed. Thank you! In 1969, the Beatles recorded a guitar overdub on Come Together and vocal, piano, organ and percussion overdubs on Sun King, Mean Mr. Mustard, during a 2:30 to 10:45 p.m. session at the EMI Studios. And with this, we can wrap up another episode of What a Fab Day. Tomorrow, we'll see the Beatles busy with another recording session, this time for their second LP, with the Beatles. Join me for this and more stories from the four you love. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.